Hey guys, Burger Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 in Westerlo, Karama, where last some stuff I picked up two more wins in the league. In one of those games, I defeated the second place team, Anderlecht, to just open a bit more of a gap to them, between them and myself. Yeah. Of course, it's those of you who know the Pro League or have been following this series so far.
Oh, hi there, Martin. Absolutely delighted.
Or will have already know that finishing first is indeed irrelevant, as it seems like the top six go into a goddamn playoff league. I don't know why. It seems irrelevant. I'll have to win more games beyond win the games of the actual league. What?
Like, good position here. And the referee does blow. The flag was up from the assist.
It's a structure. Well, I'm not gonna put too much thought into. I'm just gonna get on with
referee's done.
Making my way through the competition.
Cards in his pocket. Just a free kick.
He can game by game. Ever so closer to being qualified for said playoffs. This is game 17.
These two have got a great understanding with their passing
of the league.
That's neatly done. Good challenge by the defender. Very good control, though. Comes in strongly.
That's a free kick.
It's in a really threatening position, too. And the free kick, and that's a pretty comfortable save. Not the best set.
I didn't mean to do that. I wanted to curl it over the wall. Oh, I wasn't trying to curl it around the wall. That was a good opportunity I squandered.
Impairing a bit our visibility of the proceedings out there on the pitch.
Yeah, I mean,
nice and dry up here, but unlike the players,
if the
will be pretty wet.
Team had
5 minutes.
Defender to it.
One and two, they could have done the new thing you do on free kicks, as demonstrated by Liverpool. Well, against Spurs. With Coutinho kneeling down. I never thought I'd see that. I really didn't.
Well, that's the sort of corner that frustrates the coaches.
And you can bet that's
the delivery wasn't good enough.
That's something I've never seen before in football. I've seen hundreds. Thousands. I've seen thousands of games. And I've never seen anyone do that.
Dems. Could be dangerous.
So
to take the lead, and here it is, and a score now.
It's a interesting new little tactic, just in case you're playing a match and
when you're a goalkeeper at this level.
No, Russia team gives away a free kick in a really dangerous area. That gives the players, well, it doesn't give them the players in the wall free reign to jump up in case the ball is going high in. They think the ball is going high, and instead it's played Coutinho style under the wall.
First goal, it's 1-0.
I find it funny that Coutinho is the one who was
Peters.
Wary of that, considering it was him who
onto the attack.
Introduced us to that in the game against West Ham last season. Last season. I was gonna say, he wasn't last season, but it was.
Highland. Well, the ref's gonna
feels like
play go on
it was two seasons ago. I don't know why. I mean, I could be just associating this season with being over already, because even the people on BT Sports I think it was meant as a joke, but and the guy said you might laugh at that, but he couldn't be more right. He really couldn't. He couldn't be more right. Chelsea do indeed. Like, Chelsea will have to massively fuck up to not win the Premier League from his situation.
Forward play from them.
I mean, they're playing today when you're doing this. Of course, this is recorded
and it's a header.
On Saturday, but it's posted on Sunday.
Push their lead now to two ahead.
But
well to this point.
Now, maybe Chelsea will have the same problem against Burnley as everyone else, where Burnley seemed to turn into fucking the best team in the world when they're home against a team. But if anyone can break down from Burnley's very good home defense, it's Chelsea.
Makes a challenge here.
Now, maybe I'll be wrong, but even if they do drop points against Burnley, I still can't see them losing, because out in the title this season.
It's such a wet day, and it's been raining through halftime as well.
It's just one of those seasons. It's a blowout, really.
Strong, fair challenge.
I mean, a lot of people will tell you that they were worried. I was worried about this. I was worried that with Chelsea, he getting a new manager, I was like, okay, Conte is a good manager. We saw what he did with Italy in the Euros. We saw what he's done in the past with the likes of Juventus. If anyone can get the Chelsea back into the form you'd expect out of them, especially with the players that they have and the players that he brought in, like Alonso and
sustained attacking football,
and then N'Golo Kante.
Done now, it's just a risk that they might get caught out. Lovely one-touch football. The shot's up.
I think we were all worried that this would happen, but when Chelsea didn't, immediately shoot off, they had a slow start, but now they've gotten into the lead, and it's just, it's like a snail racing Usain Bolt, and he has a head start. I mean, unless he breaks his legs, that snail isn't going to win.
Taken quickly. I think the two teams were going to play on here, but the referee has stopped it for this injury.
So,
gone off.
Yeah.
We're going to get the game restarted with a drop ball. Well, we're 2/3 of the way through the 90 minutes, half an hour to go.
I don't see it as a joke. I think it is very much real. It's just a matter of time.
Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation.
I just can't see anyone catching them. And like I said, Chelsea will. They're just so far ahead of everyone. You just have to look and see. Yeah, they're gonna have to drop a serious amount of points. Which, when you look at Chelsea, they just, except for the odd occasion, they just don't seem like they're gonna drop points. I mean, they've had the rare blip here and there this season. But mostly, they've been solid.
If they keep playing like this.
Yeah, such a dangerous side on the counter-attack because they move the ball.
Once Conte, he got the team playing as he wanted them to play. As soon as Chelsea's form picked up, all bets may as well have been off. I mean, everyone, with how they started the season, everyone was expecting Manchester City to win, but this is similar to what they did last season.
What a fine,
really, with Man City. Last season, Man City, he started off with a whole bunch of wins. It looked like they were going to be unstoppable. Then they dropped off. Seemingly, the same thing is happening this year. Except instead of Leicester taking advantage, it's Chelsea.
Time ticking on. Just over 15 minutes to go. On the attack here. Promising build-up until that challenge. Well, the home team has been outplayed. And the home supporters have lost their will to support, I think.
Well, haven't they just? You could hear them kicked up here. Seen one or two. Heading for the exits, they're not impressed.
Into the attacking third. He might be through. He's got his shot off now. Oh, it's in there.
Keeper couldn't get anyway, that notwithstanding, I'm having
creating the chance was really good. The right pass every time now.
Well, scoring in any game is worthy of celebration.
Any match here. It's 5-0. Is that going for his hat trick? Or is it his second? I just want to see the thing pop up. Hello?
Substitute coming on. It's a tactical change.
Hurry up.
If you're losing count, it's 5-0.
That is indeed Higginbotham's hat trick. Wait, is it? No, wait, that's not right. No, stop. Oh, no. Acosta got the first goal. Sorry. My bad. Acosta got the first goal, so that was... Gamboa is on two, and Strandberg is on two. So the two main goal scorers are both...
Probing away. Trying to find room for a shot, maybe.
Well, hoping to have a hat-trick to get the match ball.
Oh. Challenges for the ball.
Attempts to take the take advantage in the
Peters
race for top goal scorer.
Well, the signal's gone up for 2 minutes. He went in well. Attacking now. Shot on! He's been waving these shots goodbye, the goalkeeper. And there's another one.
Well, the defence in front of him, Martin, has been totally dominant. And as a result, well...
The ref blows for the free kick.
I mean, if they score here, that would just be bullshit. Ooh, they almost did.
Didn't think he was
a little bit lower, and that would have been in the back of the net. I would have been pissed. But I do keep the clean sheet intact. 5-0. Oh, not a bad score. Or then, if I do say so myself, I don't know why I'm talking funny. There you can see the upcoming cup game. Which will be the opportunity for some of these young players to get their day in the sun, as it were. I'm gonna leave Heyman's in. I'm good with that team. I will be that team for the game against Standard Liège, I think it is. Yep, it is indeed. First cup game of the season, the Crocky Cup, as the game seems to be calling it. Interesting name for a competition. I'm not gonna judge it.
We're still a bit away from the players thinking about silverware and medals, but
the
stage where the competition becomes really serious in this round of 16.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting. Whether
it's probably not even pronounced like that. There's probably some way of pronouncing it I am missing, but is not an issue. Ooh, at least I don't think it is.
Performances we expect from the individuals trying to make this formation work.
Yeah, I mean, it can at first glance look cautious, but it just depends on the attitude of the players out there. And once they've got a foothold in this game, they can get a little bit more
if you
push on.
Have a problem with how I'm pronounced in the name of the cup, help let me.
Well, he's looked the manager.
You know, I want where Accord appears.
He's decided that a strong central defender is what's required.
And
he's making his debut.
Yeah.
If people
conceded one or two sloppy goals,
have an issue, I will address it.
And in an effort to stop that, he brings in
my next.
Just be able to plug some gaps.
One area I know they
run in the cup.
Difficulties from
which
into the
might not
area.
Be in my next. It's up to the game where I put the next cup game on.
Hung on to the ball well.
Considering. Unless there's two-legged affairs in this competition, which there might be. I mean, I'm
like, good strong tackle.
Again, this is my first Belgian career mode in the Belgian league for a while, so I don't remember.
It'll be a throw. Just worried about the rain.
How this competition goes.
A bit of visibility of the
was to the best of my ability.
Dry up here, but unlike the players,
who
pretty wet after 5 minutes.
I would think it's normal. I can't remember though. It could have two legs somewhere. I'm going to assume it's normal.
Well, this is how this team can play.
Each round, single limit.
In with a chance. He's kept it out.
Asian tournament where you play a team once and that's it.
Now he's looking for support. Gonna try one now. He's got his fingertips to it and it's over the bar. Referee has pointed for a corner.
So I'd assume if this match doesn't have a winner within the 90 minutes, it would go to extra time and penalties. Or maybe it has replays, but I think that's only the FA Cup. Which, if you ask me, is really stupid. Of the English of the FA Cup. I think instead of having
in his grasp.
You're just wasting people's time with the replays. Please, for God's sake. Yeah?
Tackle here. Well, he's got away from him.
If it can't be decided,
now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch.
It's
good, clean tackle.
Send their dumbasses the penalties. It's as simple as that. I mean, throw in extra time if you really he wants some more game time out of the two teams, but... Oh, no. Oh, don't send it to another match. No one cares. Yes.
Referee's pointed for a free kick here.
Yes. Because you're basically telling... That'd be like someone, a team losing and saying, oh, but we get a replay. Why?
2 minutes of
I mean, that doesn't happen in any other competition. You don't get a draw and...
With a chance to go and a score now.
Say, okay, we gotta play again. Why? We just play extra time and penalties. That's literally what those things were invented for.
Well, they've just squeezed this goal in the first half. Time almost up.
Yeah, I think we were all, and they were just looking at the ref, waiting for him to blow the half-time whistle.
I mean, at least they had the foresight of... to say, okay, you get one replay, and if that goes to a draw, then you go to extra time and penalties. But then you're like, why not do that for the first leg? I mean, if there was no extra time and penalties, and they kept drawing forever, or you'd have to come up with something. You can just let these two teams draw for the rest of the time, because maybe they are... It's just one of those games that, you know, it's just one team can't win. Because the other team just knows how to counter them, but doesn't have the offense to
on the attack here.
Meet that. I mean,
wonderful chance.
If you have a strong enough defense, all you need is to get one attack. Easy way to avoid a replay and or extra time or penalties. But if it goes to a... I would... If I was in charge of the English FA, I would be like, yeah, replays are just a waste of the time. Especially if you're a fan who... I mean... If I was going to go to an FA Cup match, I'd wait and get IR tickets to a replay match, or... Sure.
Well, Mr. Smith's eyes lit up alongside me, and he's only on the gantry. You'd love to have taken that chance.
Sure. Would have taken that tickets chance. To the semi-final or the final.
Whatever, it's a shocking miss.
If my team get that far, because they don't always do. But...
Cut out the pass.
Because basically, if the
forward with
game ends a draw, you're basically saying, okay,
throw in after that tackle.
We'll this match will happen again in a few days.
Well, he's thrown possession
do the
away.
People who, as far as I know, that the people, like I said, I don't know, maybe this is how it works, but as far as I know, you don't get it refunded your money, or at least. Said, okay, hey, you were at this game, here you go. Here's your ticket to the replay. Free ticket on us. Now, granted, yes, you couldn't do that for everyone. But for the... But a select few would get a ticket to the replay. There's who don't. You give the a refund. Because basically they watched a pointless match. Because in the league, when you get a draw, you don't look like, okay, we're gonna play again in a few days. No. They take a point each and they go home. And then the next time they play is a different fucking match.
Cross coming in now. It was a cross that he got in quickly, but he didn't really control. Now here's a chance from winning the ball. Shot on! That's going to be a corner. He's going to try his luck. Oh, no scraps for the attackers to feed on from the goalkeeper that time. Hung on to the ball well.
When you think about it, it's a kind of a silly, small thing that can easily be. He's like, okay, let's deal with this. Let's not have this be an issue.
Giving the opposition a problem with their interpassing. Onto the attack now. We know how many late goals come in this competition. They want another one now.
Well, the manager on the sidelines waving his centre halves forward. Could be boot one stuff now.
And he could get away here.
Oh, that is just sheer unlucky. Heinous for standard of the age. I feel bad, but at the same time, I feel good because that pretty much secures my place in the quarterfinals. The defender thought he had gotten the ball away from me. He gets up. My player gets up. The ball is just sitting there, or chilling, and he's like, ooh! Sticks it, Nikolic.
Restarting at 2-0.
With a nice brace to, all but ensure me. Spot in the, last 8 of this competition.
Ishak Belfodil in.
And the reason I know this is the last 16 is because there's only 16 Belgian teams.
Real opening now. And they've got in to score here. It's his third goal. It's a hat trick today. He's really been.
Anyway. Hey. That second goal isn't gonna be the only one because there's a third goal. It's Kulik again, he completes his hat-trick, and that definitely wraps that up.
Work rate, his runs off the ball, a bit top class.
That's gone out for a throw-in. Substitute coming up for the away team. Good play until they got that challenge in. 4 minutes of added time to come. Well, they're in a good position here.
Tremendous.
The goal is there for the
Milik.
It's a goal, it's in.
Oh my god. Sorry, Nikolic. Milik is a completely different player.
Zeros or zeros, it's a zero against his name here.
Well, he left his post, he's outside the 6
and getting players who are name anyway freaking similar confused. I mean, the only thing they have in common is being strikers.
4-0, the emphatic
4-0. Oh. Oh. Well, that hatcher was the icing on the cake. A real late a hat trick to add on to the goal in the first half. So yeah. Perez still can't use him. Because why the fuck would I want to? Who I mean, right? Indian manager. No, I don't want to be the Indian manager. Nor do I want to be Hungary's manager. I will stick to Westerlo. Oh. The next cup game is next month against Anderlecht. Okay. Well, that won't be the next episode because there's a game before that Anderlecht game. So that will be the first episode of the video you see on Thursday. But this wraps up the video you're going to see. Well, tomorrow when I post this. Until next time, thanks for watching, enjoy. Until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.